What's up everyone, Matt here with the Maya Learning Channel, and today I'm very excited to announce something I've literally been waiting months to share with you all. Maya 2024 is finally here. So to celebrate, I'm starting a new series where I highlight some of my favorite features in this release, as well as the scenarios where they'll make your life easier or just let you do things you couldn't do before. Today I'm going to show you a bit about the new Animation Curve Sculpting tools, which allow you to sculpt animation just like sculpting a mesh. Then in the weeks to follow, I'll show you all about improvements to retopology and make live, before finishing off by showing you how to build a facial rig using the new multi-skin feature. But wait, that's not all. In an effort to help you understand the content even better this time, I'm going to be trying something new. So I've done plenty of videos in the past where I include sample scene files for you to follow along. But for each video in this series, I'm actually going to be running through an interactive tutorial on the subject, which you can get down in the description below. This is a format that we introduced a few releases ago that provides step-by-step workflows that you can follow along with right in Maya's UI. So right after you watch this video, you can try out the workflow for yourself without having to constantly go back and forth between Maya and YouTube. Or you can even pause, grab the file right now, and follow along in real time. If you have access to Maya 2024, I highly encourage you to try these out. I've worked really hard to put these together for you, and I truly believe they offer some significant learning advantages, since you'll actually be doing the workflow yourself, and thus building up a bunch of that great muscle memory. Not only that, but because the tutorial only moves forward when you do things correctly, there's never any doubt about whether you did a step right or wrong. And finally, this format gives you the ability to really dig into the scene at any given step to see how everything works. At any time, you can click an object and check its attributes, or look in the node editor to see, oh, that's how those things are connected. All these things add up to a much fuller understanding of the material than this video alone can provide, which in turn will also speed up your ability to apply it to your own scenes. But of course, these still only represent a small fraction of the new features in Maya 2024, so be sure to check out the full list in the Maya documentation. But that's enough soapboxing for now. Let's get on to that first workflow. P.S. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. So as always with these interactive tutorials, I need to load it via the File Open menu after downloading. Double-clicking the icon from Windows or macOS won't work. As I said earlier, today I'll be showing you the new Animation Curve Sculpting tools added to the graph editor. You can use these tools to smoothly modify groups of keyframes all at once, rather than adjusting them one by one. To try it out, first play the scene to view this short little jump animation I made. Now let's use Curve Sculpting to adjust MayaBot's trajectory. First, I'll start by selecting the MayaBot asset to expose its attributes in the graph editor. Then I'll just filter the Translate Y attribute and select the Grab tool. Now, as you can see in the tutorial, I've already provided a sample of where I want the new jump height to be. And if I drag over the keyframes using the Grab tool, you can move MayaBot up and down, like so. So I'll just move it until it matches. And now if I play the animation again, you'll see that MayaBot meets that new height, but without losing the animation's overall smoothness, thanks to the sculpting falloff. So that's one simple way to use sculpt animation. Let's look at another by making MayaBot jump further. First, I'll go to frame 54. Then I'll use the Move tool to move MayaBot a bit further along, which again I've highlighted in the tutorial. Then I'll set a keyframe by pressing S. And play the animation again. As you can see, the animation plays out largely the same, except between frames 53 and 54, where there's a sudden jump. You can see that jump in curve form by filtering on Translate Z. Let's fix that using our sculpt tools. First, I'll drag select all the keys from 28 to 53. You'll see why in a moment. This time I'll use the smear tool. Just a quick side note that double-clicking any of these icons will open the tool settings, where I can set the brush size and strength. I can also do this by holding B or M and dragging the mouse button, just like the modeling sculpt tools. Now, unlike the grab tool that I used earlier, the smear tool allows me to move both up and down and horizontally across the curve at the same time. So starting at frame 28, I'll drag the brush diagonally along the curve to raise it up towards the changed keyframe at frame 54. Also note that as I work, only the selected keyframes move. This is why I selected them earlier, since it's a good way to ensure you don't accidentally move keyframes you didn't mean to. You probably won't end up with a perfectly straight line in one try, but that's what the smooth tool is for. Now if I play the animation again, you can see my bot jumps further and faster than before, but still in one smooth motion. So those are two cases for modifying some very straightforward existing motions, but you can use curve sculpting to create all new motions too. For example, let's use them to add an arm flailing animation to my bot as it falls. Once again, my tutorial provides you with an example rig to follow. So I'll start by selecting my bot's left wrist effector. Then I'll control select the example's left wrist effector. That'll lay the animation graphs for both on top of each other in the graph editor, which is a lot to look at. So I'll start by filtering just their respective Y attributes. There, that's a lot clearer. Now I can just use the same tools as before to match my bot's curve to the example. Then repeat for translate Z, and rotate Y. And then I'll repeat for the right wrists. And of course, for the purposes of this tutorial, I provided these handy example graphs to match to. But once you're more comfortable with the feature, you can totally just freehand these curves to create new motions. Though as you might expect, this really works best for flowy, smooth, or patterned motions. And I should point out that I've included a handy little skip button here in case you can't quite get the exact placement of the keys to match the example. Now if I play the animation, you can see my bot flail its arms as it falls. So that's curve sculpting in a nutshell. Again, if you haven't already, I really recommend downloading this tutorial file and giving it a try, since you can learn so much more just by playing around with it beyond what I've showed you. And if you're so inclined, leaving a thumbs up or down and a comment at the end of this tutorial really helps guide the content that I'm making for you all. And finally, for the keeners out there, I should mention that all the interactive tutorials I mentioned at the start of this video are already up and available for download if you want to try them after this. Or you can wait until I cover them in the upcoming videos. The choice is up to you. See you then!